Good morning, golf geeks. Welcome back to Slice Right Golf. I'm going to do a vlog today, something I've never done before, but I'm going to give it a go because today I have the privilege of being invited to play at the London Club, a very, very good golf course down in Kent. A good friend of mine who you met on one of my previous videos, Scott the Mute, he's managed to get a four ball here and has invited me to come and play. So to say I'm excited is an understatement. It's a championship course. We're playing the heritage course. Obviously a European tour has been held there. The course was opened by Jack Nicklaus and Seve Ballesteros, so it sort of shows how good the course is just by the two players that opened the course. I mean, Seve's my dad's hero, so you know, for me it's quite an honour to play at a course that he's played at. But again, I'm very excited. I'm looking forward to the day. I'm nervous as well because obviously I want to play good golf, but not knowing the course, never been here before. There's two people that I don't know that I'm playing with, so that's always a little bit nerve-wracking because you never know how you're going to play in front of them. But no, I am looking forward to it. I'm making my way down there now. We've got a 9 o'clock tee off, so give myself plenty of time to get there. So I'm going to do a vlog. You know, hopefully they'll let me film around the clubhouse, maybe the putting green, the range. I'll do a couple of little videos while I'm on the course. Because again, this might never happen again. It's like a once in a lifetime opportunity for me. I don't know anyone that plays there to ever get invited back. So I want to make the most of it. I want to enjoy it, but I want to try and get a bit of it on footage, because for you Slice Right golf fans out there, as I say, you golf geeks of mine, I'd like you to see what it's like to play a course like this. Good or bad, depending on how I play. I'm not too sure how I'm going to play, but yeah, we'll give it a go. I'm making my way down there now, so we'll see when we get there. So golf geeks, just coming over the Dartford Bridge, making our way into Kent, getting nearer the course. The excitement's building, the nerves are kicking in. I really, really want to play well today. Not just because I'm playing with people I don't know, but these are courses you don't get to play often. These are courses that they're tests, and you want to test yourself on the best courses, but you don't get the option to play. You don't get the chance to play in this course. It's not someone like me anyway. You know, if my channel grew, which hopefully it will, you never know, you might get invited to these sort of places to play golf. And while I'm talking about the channel, as I've just gone over 100 subscribers, I'd like to say thank you to all of you out there that are following me, that are subscribed to my channel. It means a lot. I really appreciate it. I enjoy doing it. It's something I find, you know, I love doing it. It's a bit of fun. It's interesting to me. It's a hobby of mine. I love golf. I'm a golf geek as well. And the fact that I've got 100 people that are looking at my channel and watching me, it does mean a lot, and I really, really appreciate it. To those that don't follow me or subscribe, please like, please subscribe. If you like the sort of stuff that I do, please like it, please subscribe, get the channel growing. I'm going to look to play with some other people. I've got some friends I've made on YouTube that have helped me along the way. Golf Days, Bogey Golf, they've been good to me. They've given me some tips and help that they've used for their channel. So I'm hoping to try and meet up with a couple of them and maybe get around the golf, get on their channel and play. That might boost my channel. But today's all about the London Club. I am buzzing for this. I don't know if you can tell, I might not be that excited, but honestly, I am buzzing for this. Nervous, and I don't normally get nervous about things like this because golf's golf, but I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be good. So golf geeks, we have arrived, and already it's impressive. Got to the front gate, got met at reception by a lovely lady. She asked who I was here to play with. I mentioned the guy's name, 9 o'clock tee off. She asked for my name and she then said, "Have a lovely day, Stuart," which was lovely. Driving down this road into this course, it is impressive. Very, very impressive, geeks. The the butterflies have increased. It's just absolutely immaculate looking from left to right. Either side of this roadway in, there's fairways and greens. There's two courses here. You've got the international course and you've got the heritage course. We're playing the heritage course today. But this is absolutely stunning, people. Absolutely stunning. I'm never normally lost for words, but it's hard to describe. The greens look like carpet. It's just beautiful, absolutely beautiful. I'm going to enjoy this. I am going to enjoy this. Everywhere you look, it's just lush fairways, lush greens. One thing I have noticed already, and it probably will be a factor for me, the rough's thick and high. It's some of it's waist high that I'm going past here. So, I mean, we're just coming up to the building now, and what a gaff this is, Jesus Christ. I've come the right way, mate, and I. First time, morning, mate, first time being, I've come the right way. Do I just go in the car park or come around this way?
Well, drop your clubs here, we put a tag on it, then you go car park.
Oh, wow, please. Okay. Yeah. I mean, guys, that's a first. That is a first for me. That is turning up and they take your bag, they put a tag on it. That is a first. Very impressed so far, people. Very impressed, golf geeks. This is one hell of a place. One hell of a place.
What a beautiful course, golf geeks. What a beautiful course. London Club Heritage Course, number 7, par 3. Wow.
So, golf geeks, reached the turn. To be honest, like I expected, the golf wasn't great for me, but the course, it's absolutely immaculate. It's absolutely stunning. Beautiful course, the greens are just, they're fast. I mean, when you get on the first tee and there's an announcer or there's a guy on the tee box and he tells you what the stint meter is and how fast the greens are, you know you're playing somewhere pretty decent, which is what we got. But yeah, it didn't do too bad. 48 for the front nine, which, do you know what, I'm going to take that. I don't know where I'm going. Some shots, it's some blind shots, but it's a tough course. Bunkers are everywhere, they're deep. I'm not moaning, I'm saying how good it is. This course is immaculate, it's just beautiful. And again, it's a privilege to play. I'm gonna turn this round, try and show you what it looks like. Look, it's just absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. It's just stunning, absolutely stunning. Yeah, golf geeks. This is beautiful. This is what I call enjoying a round of golf. And it ain't about what I'm playing or the strokes that I'm hitting, scores that I'm getting. This is just enjoyable to walk around a course as beautiful as this. On a sunny day, sunny summer's day in England, just can't ask for anything better. I mean, if you get the opportunity to play here, don't turn it down. Play, definitely accept the option, do what you can. I had to take a day off work today to play here, but at the moment it's worth it. My golf isn't, but I don't care. I'm not bothered about my standard of play. I'm just making the most of this opportunity. These greens are rapid, and I mean rapid. Beautiful greens, they're just so quick. You've got to be able to read a green. You've got to be able to judge your distances. They are very quick, very, very quick. So, golf geeks, we are on the 18th on the Heritage Course at the London Club. What a place. What a golf course. This place is different gravy, different level that I've ever played. Best course I've ever played on, if I'm being honest. Fairways are beautiful. Every part, there's not one bit of it that is wrong. There's nothing wrong with it at all. Coming down the 18th now, that'll turn that round. How beautiful is that? How beautiful is that? It's been a pleasure to play on this course. Thanks to Scott the Mute for inviting me. Part of DP World, he got to play on here. So that's been a pleasure to play. Loved every minute of it. apart from the golf. Golf's been shocking, but it's a tough course. It's a championship course. This is what like European tour players play on. So I wasn't expecting me to go round here flushing it and, you know, chipping in and putting. But I've done all right. Score's not been too bad on the last hole now. So it's been a pleasure to play in. But what a place. London Club, you have excelled yourself. This place is out of this world. It's brilliant. Hello golf geeks, I am leaving what I can only say has been one of the best golf courses I've played on in my golfing career, probably at present. You know, fingers crossed I get to play some other golf courses. Let's get this YouTube lifestyle going and maybe I'll get invited to play a few other courses. But that one was, in my opinion, one of the best. The greens were unbelievably quick. But a test, they weren't undulating and, you know, dips. They were just quick. They were just hard to read. They were just well looked after, well maintained. It was just beautiful. I'm a bit lost for words, if I'm being honest, guys. It was beautiful, you know. To be a member there must be a pleasure for people. It must be expensive. Don't get me wrong, must be well expensive to be a member there, but if you're playing them sort of greens every week, you've got to be a good putter. You've got to be a good player. The course weren't long. The heritage course we played on wasn't long. I mean, some of the par fives, I birdied one of the par fives, which shows that they're doable, and I had a chance on the other par fives, but it's just a long, not long, it's just a tough course. The design of the course is why it's tough. It's designed to be a challenging course and they maintain it that well, and them greens are just that good. It was just beautiful. I've loved every minute of today, every minute of it. The golf was shocking. I'll be honest with you guys, I had a 93. I'll try and put the card on the screen somewhere. I had a 93, I had a 9, an 8, 2 8s or a couple of 7s, I can't remember now. But to be honest, I wasn't really bothered about the score today. The score to me was not what it was about. It was just enjoying the fact that I've had a chance to play on a golf course that, you know, it's a European Tour golf course. It holds major events. And for me, you don't get that opportunity every day. You don't get the chance to play on them every day. So to be able to do that was a pleasure. It was an honor. I appreciate it. And, you know, it'd be nice maybe next time to play better golf. I didn't play that bad today. I still scored 31 points because with the world golf system, my handicap was 14 today playing that course, where normally I'm about 12. I was 14 today and I still got 31 points, which if he was playing a staple for competition, it's not too bad. So I'm not going to moan about that. The score wasn't that bad, but it would be nice to have gone round there and played some good golf, hit some nice shots. I mean, my last break 80 quest, my driver, I was kissing it at one of the holes. Today I could have broke it in half. I was awful with my driver today. My putting, I put a video up about my putting being great. Today I was awful, but that was down to the conditions of the course because they were that good. They were of that high standard, which is above me. I'm big enough to say that course was above my level of golf. That course was for players. I'd say there's not many golfers that go around that course that play 28 handicap regularly. It's a golf course that you've got to be a good golfer to play on that golf course. You have to be. So I imagine most of the people that play on that golf course are low handicappers. But again, I wasn't there for that. I wasn't there to try and prove a good golfer. I was there just to enjoy being able to play on a golf course that was that good, that was that high standard, that level of golf that I want to get to. I want to get to a level of golf where that's the sort of course, the course that I want to play on, that I want to be, you know, looking at. And again, it was a privilege, it was an honour. I'm appreciative, and you know, I just really enjoyed today. It was great. My score wasn't great, the golf wasn't great, but it was just beautiful, absolutely beautiful, guys. If anyone out there sees this and wants a average golfer who's a mid to high handicapper to come and review their golf course, please pick me. I'd love to review golf courses of that level and say what they're like, because that was beautiful today. That was absolutely stunning.